Hello everyone,
this is Chris from the KUKA simulations team, and today I'm going to show you how to make a safe operation configuration in KUKA.Sim. First up front, a short disclaimer, this video is not a substitute for the safe operation product documentation or the KUKA college course, and I'm going to show you a short example of a robot in a cell, but of course you'll have to adapt it to your own application and in the end verify it with WorkVisual and test it on a real robot before doing the safety acceptance test following the product documentation. What I'm going to show you in part one of this sequence is the activation of KUKA Safe Operation in KUKA.Sim and then the configuration of the cell area and the safe tool. In the second part, I'll show you the safe spaces and the reference position, and then in a third part, the export to WorkVisual and also the KUKA Stop Service. I'm going to use KUKA.Sim 4.1 and Safe Operation 3.6 and WorkVisual 6.0. Let's jump right into the tool. Here I have the KUKA College cell, and once I go down here to Devices, I have the Safe Configuration option here. Once I click on it, I have to select the Safe Operation bundle there, and then all the points that were grayed out before are now white. But first I have to activate it with the tick in the box up here, and then I see, okay, directly the cell configuration is green. That's what we are going to start with. You can actually select a corner and drag and drop them to the cell edges that you need. Or you can use the snap function and just snap it wherever you need to. So I'm just going to do this real quick. And if you want to add a new corner, this is also very easy with that. But then it's generated on the robot. So you'll have to first select it and then drag and drop it outside of the other four corners so it gets green. Now I'm going to make the cell configuration invisible so it doesn't disturb me. And I'm going to reduce the height to 2.50 meters because 5 meters is way too much. Now let's have a look at the tool. There is already one tool added here in a sphere, as you can see, but you can add more tools over here. We're going to use this one tool. Actually, we already have one, and you can add new spheres for the safe monitoring here. But first you have to activate them. Now I'm just going to use them to wrap my tool. I'm just going to put one over the wrist. The next one, the sphere 2, I'm going to reduce it a little bit in the size and put it on the TCP. Of course, this one you can also snap it. So when you add another sphere, I'm going to reduce the size again. It's a little bit too big. 80 millimeters is the thing I want. You can snap it again wherever you need to. I'm just going to put it back a little bit. Be sure to wrap all the cables and extensions of your gripper. I'm going to need one more sphere and put it over the cables here. Okay. Bigger. Okay. Now that I have my tool ready, I can enter the coordinates of my TCP here. I can also snap it between the spheres that I need. So for example, if I snap the midpoint between here and there. I have my TCP directly generated here. This will be handy for the velocity monitoring because it's from the TCP. Thanks for watching the first part. We'll have a second part and a third part. Feel free to join again. Feel free to write your comments in the box below. And I'll be happy if you join again for the next video about the Cartesian and X-specific workspaces. And see you there. Have a nice one.
Industrial intelligence.